pain in right iliac fossa. When a patient presents with pain in right iliac fossa, the common causes that should come to your mind are appendicitis, amoebic colitis, and right ureteric colic. All of these can be either mild or severe. So first you should take a proper history to ascertain the nature of the pain. Is it colicky or continuous? And is it radiating to the back, to the perineum or urethra? A severe colic is usually due to a ureteric stone. But pain of appendicitis and amoebic colitis can also be colicky. A colicky pain radiating from the loin to the groin or to the urethra is typical of a ureteric colic. It is usually associated with some urinary symptoms. So ask specifically for history of dysuria, hematuria or hesitancy. And most importantly, there is no significant tenderness in abdomen in case of ureteric colic. This is very important because in the other two conditions, that is appendicitis and amoebic colitis, there will always be tenderness. So severe or moderate tenderness practically rules out ureteric colic. In acute appendicitis, we have two types. One is inflammatory, where the patient has continuous pain, and the second is obstructive type, where the lumen is obstructed by a fecolith or a kink and the patient gets intermittent colicky pains. Appendicitis will be usually associated with fever and history of vomiting. It is a triad of pain in right iliac fossa, fever and vomiting. And on palpation in right iliac fossa, always there is localized tenderness and guarding. While palpating the right iliac fossa, palpate gently first, followed by deep palpation. Note the exact site of tenderness. Then locate the McBurney's point between anterior superior iliac spine and umbilicus. In appendicitis, the point of maximum tenderness is at or a little medial to the McBurney's point. If appendicitis is acute, there will also be tachycardia, which is not seen in ureteric colic and amoebiasis. In amoebic colitis, pain and colonic tenderness is often located in right iliac fossa, but some tenderness will also be seen on the left colon. If there is history of dysentery with mucus in stools, it is strongly in favor of amoebic colitis. The pain is associated with tenesmus and is reduced after passing motions. Another point, in amoebic colitis, the appetite is normal. But in appendicitis, appetite is reduced and there may be nausea. When you are palpating over the right iliac fossa, if there is gurgling felt over the cecum, it again suggests amoebic colitis. So by taking into consideration the history and examination findings, you can make a clinical diagnosis of the cause of pain in right iliac fossa. Now we will consider the treatment in acute appendicitis. Sometimes there is severe tenderness and guarding. In such a case, give an analgesic injection like injection Voveron 3cc, injection Emicet if the patient is vomiting, and a higher antibiotic like injection Cetil, and then refer the patient immediately to a surgeon. For milder cases, start an antibiotic like injection Sephentral or Ofloxacin, and an anti-amoebic, tab tinidazole, ornidazole or tab flagyl. For colicky pains, give injection Enafortan or Spasmindon, otherwise give injection Voveron. If there is nausea or vomiting, IV fluids and IV antibiotics will have to be given for the first 2 days. The diagnosis should be confirmed by ultrasonography and high WBC count. If the patient has a ureteric colic, give an antispasmodic injection first like Enafortan or Spasmoproxivon. If the pain is severe, give a strong analgesic injection like injection fortuin, tramadol or voveron as and when necessary. Give 2 pints of 5% dextrose followed by 1 ampule of Lasix to increase the urine flow. Orally, give Cital 1 teaspoonful in a glass of water 3 times a day. Advise to drink 2.5 to 3 liters of fluids every day and give Tabcistone or Neri 1 TDS. But it is very important to make a definitive diagnosis. So get the urine checked for RBCs, get X-ray and ultrasound of KUB and then treat accordingly. In case of amoebic colitis, advise Tabtinidazole 500 mg BD for 5 days or Ornidazole or Flagyl. For pain, give Tab Enafortan or Spasmindon and for more severe pain, injection Enafortan. If the diagnosis is doubtful, ask for stool examination.